In Unity, a script is considered as a custom component, and often you'll need to access other scripts attached to the same game object or even on other game objects. You can access other scripts and components using GetComponent. In this example, both another script and yet another script both have public variables within them. We'd like to be able to affect those variables in our using other components script. We have three variables here, one to store another game object, and two to store references to the other scripts. Note that the references to the other scripts are simply variables whose type is the name of the script. This is because what we're actually referencing is an instance of the class defined in the script. For more information, see the lesson on classes linked below this lesson. In the awake function, we initialize our variables. The getComponent function uses a slightly different style of call to what we're used to. We use a pair of angle brackets before the normal brackets. These angle brackets are for taking a type as a parameter. In our case, the type will be another script. We can also call getComponent to address components on other game objects that we have references to, like other game object. GetComponent will return a reference to any component of the type specified on the game object it's called upon. So in this example, I'm addressing my another script, which is on the same object as using other components, my main script. So I can say getComponent and address the player score directly. But if I want to address the number of player deaths, I'll use othergameObject.getComponent to address the other script on the cube. That way I can affect the number of player deaths directly. Whilst getComponent is most commonly used for accessing other scripts, it can also be used to access other components that are not exposed by the API. For example, the collider that you normally access by typing collider is a non-specific collider. A sphere collider has different properties to a box collider, for example. And if you want to access these properties in scripts, you can do so by using getComponent. For example, I can address the box collider on the other game object by saying boxcol is equal to othergameObject.getComponent box collider. I can then use my boxcol variable to address any of the parameters on that component on the other game object. So for example, I can address the size and set it to 3 when the scene starts. Something to note about GetComponent is that it's expensive in terms of processing power and should be called as infrequently as possible. It's often good practice to call it in the awake or start functions or only once when it's first needed.